Hi, I'm Tim Williams of Dwyer Williams Potter Injury Accident Attorneys. I'm the lead litigation attorney for our firm. Every so often, I get a client come into my office and they've been diagnosed with shoulder tendonitis. What is tendonitis? Well, technically, it is inflammation of a tendon. But here's how it relates to an accident. And I think the model will best illustrate this. Here, we see a model of the shoulder. This is your collarbone, so this is in the front of your shoulder. This is your head, would be sitting right here. Your ribs would be right here in front of this, and what this is actually the shoulder blade itself. And this is the arm bone coming up and extending into the joint. And you can see that the muscles are attached to the bones with tendons. These are the tendons here. These are actually the rotator cuff tendons we see. There's ligaments up here. There's also tendons coming up the arm itself. This would be the biceps tendon. And if we take this off, we can see where the biceps tendon actually comes around and attaches on the inside of the arm bone. And so what occurs then in tendonitis cases is it's these tendons, it's the wide areas we see in here that become inflamed. They can become inflamed by a direct impact. They can become inflamed by a stretching injury where there's ripping and tearing, even micro tears inside. And that causes pain. And the problem with that, you'd think that, well, the pain might go away within a few days, and sometimes it does. But the problem with the tendonitis is that, particularly in people with some degree of arthritis, in other words, there's a little bit of spurring in their bones and their tendons are aged, they're not as healthy as, let's say, an 18-year-old's, is that the tendons, first and foremost, they don't have great blood supply. That's why they're white, and so they don't heal very well. But secondly, the tendons, when they do become inflamed because of pain, the pain causes more inflammation, which then causes more pain, which causes more inflammation. So it's a circular process, this pain-inflammation process, that causes these injuries, as seemingly minor as they are, to become incredibly painful and problematic. So what does a doctor do when they're diagnosed with tendonitis? There are multiple things they do. First, they prescribe medication generally, and then they also tell you to take it easy, use ice to handle the inflammation, rest your shoulder, don't use it. If that doesn't work, they might move on to injection therapy. So they might inject pain medication and anti-inflammatories into the shoulder to try to handle it that way. If that doesn't work, they might move on to physical therapy where they're actually getting you to exercise a shoulder, which sounds counterintuitive, but they exercise the shoulder in these particular ways that actually increases the strength of the surrounding muscles. And so it reduces the friction and the stress on that particular tendon that's inflamed. And that'll give it a break and allow it to heal. Or ultimately, in the very rare case, they may perform surgery. They actually go in and they shave off the portion of the tendon that's it's either frayed or inflamed, or they may cut out the tendon completely and reattach it. Insurance companies try to take advantage of the situation. They claim that tendonitis is not very traumatic, that it can't hurt that bad, that take a pain pill, you'll be fine. That's not always the case. Remember, sometimes surgery is necessary. Sometimes tendonitis can become permanent, and sometimes, in fact, most of the time, insurance companies will fight you tooth and nail on it, and that's why you need a good lawyer.